ARIA, which stands for Accessible Rich Internet Applications, is a set of attributes that help you make the HTML elements more accessible, and they're making it easier for accessibility technologies and assistive technologies such as screen readers to read and understand. And how ARIA attributes work is they always start with the ARIA prefix, or some of them, and then afterwards you need a dash, and after the dash is the action you want the attribute to take. So you can have like label, which labels the current element with a custom text, or you can have something like ARIA expanded, which shows whether or not the current element is expanded. For example, if you have a hamburger menu. I want to show you a real life example of me using ARIA. Right here I have a hamburger, and I have it on default ARIA expanded false. So whenever a user opens my website on their phone, the hamburger is collapsed, and thus I have the ARIA expanded set to false. However, whenever they click on the hamburger, you can see it here, but I have written a JavaScript that toggles the ARIA expanded value from false to true. This is the JavaScript snippet I wrote. It just simply evaluates the current attribute and sets it to true or false, you know, respectively. And screen readers will read whenever the hamburger is open and ARIA expanded is set to true, it will read as expanded, and then when I close it, the screen readers will announce collapsed. This is very good for accessibility, and this can only be done using the ARIA attributes. Let's look at another example where you might use ARIA label, and this is where I use ARIA label a lot. This is where I use it whenever I have icons inside links. For example, whenever I want to link the Facebook or the Instagram profiles to the company, usually in their footer or somewhere in their site. Now, the problem is, this is not very accessible if you just add the icon inside the anchor tag, because there's no text. So whenever screen readers come across the icons for the social media sites, they read it as either they read the href, which is www.instagram.com, or they just say visited link or unvisited link. And this is very undescriptive. So whenever if people are having visual impairments and they rely on screen readers, they wouldn't know that they're hovering over or they have focused a social media link. So what I do is, inside the SVG tag, I use aria-label, and inside here I write follow company on Instagram. And this is great because sighted users will not see this text, but screen readers will announce it, and that is why it makes the social media icons very accessible. And I see very little companies have that, so make sure that your social media icons are accessible with ARIA label. So another ARIA attribute I use very often is aria-labelledby. Now what it does is, if I have an image and image have a caption, instead of copying and pasting the caption inside the alt attribute and having to change that at both locations every time the caption changes, what I like to do is I have the alt attribute empty, and then I use aria labeled by, make sure I spell that right, and then the value of that attribute, I use the ID of my caption. In this case, the ID of my caption is simply caption. So this is really neat, since every time I change the caption, this automatically changes in here, since the aria-labelledby gets the ID of the caption to use as if I have populated the out attribute. So whenever the screen readers come across the image, they will read the caption and they won't just read the file name of the image. So I think this is really good and I often use it. It makes the code don't repeat yourself, you know, the dry principle. So only have to change once here in the caption, and the image gets the alt text changed as well, instead of changing it there too. Okay, another ARIA attribute I want to talk to you about, guys, is actually doesn't have the ARIA prefix. You know, the ARIA attributes we saw this far were ARIA label and or ARIA expanded, and they both have the ARIA prefix. Now this one doesn't have it. This is called the row attribute. Now what the row attribute does is, if you have an element that is not doing what it's semantically meant to do. You can change its semantics with the raw attribute, okay? So let me show you an example. I have here this image, okay? However, this image is actually functioning as a button because every time I click it, I have output clicked in the console. Or you can have this image do anything you want. You know how you sometimes have images that when you click on them, you have alert messages, or you make them do something using JavaScript. And this is what I did with this image. Now, right now, this is very inaccessible because whenever screen readers read the image, they will just read the alt attribute. I mean, there's no alt attribute, they will just read the image file name, and that's really bad. So people using screen readers wouldn't know that this image is actually a button because we're using the image tag instead of the button tag, which is the semantic one. However, to make this image into a semantic button, what we have to do is use the row attribute, okay? This is the aria attribute, so we're gonna say row equals, and we're gonna have it equal to button. And now whenever screen readers read the image, they will say button, and people would know, oh, okay, so this is a button, so I have to interact with it somehow. I have to hover over it or click it, and I'm gonna get an output from it, okay? So this is what row does. Now, whenever you want to change an element to being interactive, for example, if you have a span that wants to act like a link, or you have a div, or in this case, we have an image that we want to act as a button, make sure after you have added row button, you add tabindex 0. Okay, this is very important, and let me show you why. Right now I have row button, and I am clicking tab, but it is not focusing the image, or in this case, our image button, okay? This is because we haven't added a tab index yet. But if we go ahead and add a tab index, this will add this image into the tab order. So I have added this, I'm clicking here, and voila, I click tab and the image is outlined. So it makes it easier to interact with. And if someone is using the keyboard, you want to make sure that they can focus every single interactive element on the page, be it a link, a button, or a form input field. So use row button whenever you want to make a non-button element like a div or an image behave like a button. And there are so many aria attributes, you know, just go into the documentation and check them out. There are so many for every single thing you might need. There's also a lot of row attributes, okay? They're not just confined to buttons. For example, before HTML5, what people would do is instead of using the main element like we have now, we needed somehow to show to the users what the main content of the page is. So what we do is use div row main, or if we wanted to show that the header is a header, we would use div row header. Okay, nowadays you don't need that because you just have the main or the header elements, but this is how useful row and aria, and the row attribute is also part of the aria, it just have a different names than aria. So read up on them on documentation and use them very often.